Today we're going to look at calibrating an eagle with a chlorine supertoxic sensor. And to do that, we're using a 2 ppm cylinder of chlorine with a nitrogen balance. And we also have a standard probe assembly and also a 3-foot section of polyurethane tubing. And then a little potentiometer screwdriver to adjust the pot there. And we'll note that we do have a pretty much a full cylinder here with a pressure gauge right at about 500 psi there. Okay, so I've got the probe attached via the quick neck fitting already, so it's nice and snug there. And now we're just going to turn the unit on and do an air adjustment before we do any calibrations. So displaying the minimum battery and the current battery voltage, going through a diagnostics countdown. After it goes through this countdown, it's going to display the active gases online right now, and everything's okay, and we are going into normal operation at this point. So at this point, I want to press and hold the air button. I'm going to press that down. We want to establish a good zero here in clean air. Hold air key, reading zero data, and release air key, and then we're back to the normal operation screen. If we had a battery sensor that failed a zero, we would now be seeing a fail condition on this unit. So everything is good now that we're back to the normal operation screen. To get into the calibration menu, I'm going to press and hold the shift down arrow button and then press the display button. That brings up the calibration menu. We need to go into single calibration mode to calibrate this super toxic chlorine sensor, so I'm going to bring that cursor down with the arrow key to the single calibration selection, press power enter to select that. That brings us to methane, oxygen, H2S, and CO. I'm going to use my down arrow key to bring that cursor down to chlorine and then press power enter to select that. Okay, so now we've got zeros flashing and we can apply the gas to the unit. So I'm going to connect one end here, of course, of the tubing to the hose barb of the regulator, which is a demand flow regulator. So this gas will not flow until the vacuum action of the pump is actually opens up the valve and starts to pull that gas from the cylinder. To attach the tubing to the probe tip, it's easier to press this collar in on the fitting and then simply pull the hard tubing section out. And in this way, I can get a good angle on it that's comfortable. And then we want to kind of roll this on at an angle. There we go. And get that soft tubing over the hard tubing section. That seems to be enough there. And then we want to just press this firmly. You want to press firmly to hear it. Seat. And then that'll ensure that there's no leaks. So now we're climbing up there in our concentration. We want to let that reading stabilize before we make any adjustments. You want to make that adjustment at 2 minutes or less. So if the reading happens to stabilize in less than 2 minutes, then we'll make the adjustment and make it match the cylinder. If it's still climbing and is not stabilized by then, we're going to go ahead and make the adjustment at 2 minutes anyway. That's our standard operating procedure for these super toxic sensor types. Another thing I want to mention is these electrochemical super toxic sensors require a bias voltage at all times. So when you're storing the unit, you want to make sure that those batteries never die in the unit. If you have alkalines or NiCads, either one, please make sure that they never die, because the sensor might die itself if that bias voltage is eliminated from being applied to that sensor. And that can happen in a matter of days. So I would recommend monthly that you check the battery voltage on your batteries. Make sure that they're at least 4.5 volts, and that'll ensure that enough bias voltage gets to the sensor. Okay? So we've got about maybe another half a minute to go here for our exposure, and we're at 2.85, so we're responding pretty strongly here to the gas. Again, we need to make that reading read 2.00 ppm. Okay, about another 15 seconds or so. And this is one method of calibrating the unit, and that's just using the push buttons to raise and lower the concentration on the screen. Okay, now we're at 2 minutes basically. So I'm going to make the adjustment now by just holding that down arrow key, drop that reading down to 2.00. There we are. Now press power enter. That concludes that calibration. I'm going to quickly take the tubing off the regulator that stops the flow of gas. The unit does not say calibration pass or anything like that. Basically, if it doesn't fail, that means it passed. And I want to now lower that cursor to escape. Press the power enter button. Calibration, single calibration end, and now we're back to the calibration menu. Once again, using the down arrow key, bring that cursor to normal operation. Press select to select that, and we're back to the normal operation screen. So basically, that's how you calibrate the unit using the push buttons. Okay, next, we're going to look at calibrating the unit using the potentiometers on the amplifier board inside. We may need to do that in the event that you are not able to span the reading high enough to match the cylinder using your push buttons. So if you ever have that condition where you can't get enough adjustment, either direction, either low or high, then that would be an occasion to remove these screws, take the top case off, and then make the adjustment using the potentiometer there. Okay? So what we have here is the Eagle has this large rectangular super toxic sensor, as we call them. This one being for chlorine. We have an amplifier board. We have a zero potentiometer and a span potentiometer. So I'm just going to, first of all, do the span right now. We know the unit was zeroed okay. It zeroed okay with the push buttons. If you could not zero the instrument with the push buttons, what you would do is raise the value to just above zero and then try pressing the air adjust button again. If that still fails, then you can actually try to adjust this zero potentiometer and zero it that way. But there's actually a procedure for doing that as well. And we'll do that now, in fact, since I mentioned it. What we need to do is I'm going to turn the unit off. And we need to be in a certain mode to do this. And it says goodbye. Okay, now I'm going to press these three buttons down firmly. You got to press them pretty hard. And then press the power button. And ROM number and sum are displayed with a program number as well. So now we're in the mode that we need to be in, millivolts. And what we need to do is channel 6 or 7 are associated with the super toxic sensors. So if you have a super toxic sensor installed, it would be reading close to 1,000 millivolts, which this one is 1,022 on channel number 6. Channel number 7 is way down at 28 millivolts, so nowhere near 1,000. So there is no super toxic connected whatsoever to that channel. There can only be two on board at one time. So now I am going to adjust this zero potentiometer. So I'll get my little screw pot over that. And I'm just going to turn that up so you can see how that channel number 6 millivolt reading is responding. I turned it up high on purpose. Now I'm going to bring it down as close to 1,000 millivolts as I can. If you ever have a condition where you turn the Eagle on and it says chlorine fail or ammonia fail or whatever super toxic sensor you have, even if it's an infrared sensor, fail. If that's the only sensor that's failing, go into this mode and then make this adjustment with a zero potentiometer as close to 1,000 millivolts as you can. Once you've done that, 9 times out of 10, your fail condition is going to go away. I'll just bring that on down pretty close. That's a little bit too low. I'd rather be a little bit too high than too low. Okay, that's really good there. Okay, so we're nice and zeroed. Then I'm going to press the power enter button. That gets us back to normal operation screen. And now I'm going to go back into single cal mode. Oh, Got to do the countdown, sorry. We're going through a diagnostics warm-up. So I let it get back to its normal operation stream. Okay, now we're going to get into the calibration menu again. And then go back to single cal, select that, go back down to chlorine, and select that. So once again, we're at a point where we can apply the gas. And so I'll go ahead and do that now. I'm already connected on the tubing, on the probe tip end already. So now we're starting our climb again. Now we're going to flow this gas. So we're climbing here. One of the things that you want to make sure when you air adjust any sensor in the Eagle is that you are in a gas-free atmosphere. You definitely don't want to try an air adjustment if you think you may have a gas background, because then it'll obviously zero itself to that gas background, which would not be good. You do have to be in a fresh air environment. If you're ever in a hazardous atmosphere, such as an explosive classified atmosphere, you want to make sure that you have the unit in a safe area before you open it up. It's still intrinsically safe if you open it up, but just to be safe, it would be best to take it to a safe area. Okay, so we're climbing up still, and we're almost to 2 ppm. We've probably got about another 20 seconds to go here for our gas exposure. One thing that you'll notice too is if you keep applying gas to the sensor over and over and over again, it will slowly become desensitized as the sensor electrolyte saturates. So you want to be careful not to keep applying gas to it over and over and over, or for very long, long periods of time, because then you are going to slow your sensor response as well as lower the sensor response. So I'm going to say that, let's say for the sake of argument, that I was trying to do my adjustment. So I'm trying to press my up arrow key. Let's say I'm below 2 ppm. I'm holding down the arrow key. It's going to beep, 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 beep. And it's going to go as high as it can. And if it still is not high enough, then at this point, I will adjust the span potentiometer. And I'm going to turn that clockwise to raise that up. Okay, so this one's not going up, so the span might be as high as it's going to go anyway, which could be the case. There's also a gain pot marked G, which is further down the amplifier board. And if you need it to go higher, you could also turn the gain pot up just a little bit. It is marked G for gain, and that is a very gross adjustment. And the point I'm trying to make is you want to use the potentiometers to overshoot the range that you need to. And once you've done that, then use your push buttons to bring it back down. So you want your span pot to be wider than your push button range. That way you can always be assured that you can calibrate with the push buttons. Okay, that's basically how you would calibrate the unit using the potentiometers. And press the cursor to escape and the single calibration mode back to normal operation. Okay, so our alarm one condition. I've still got gas flowing. I did not disconnect the gas, which is fine. We'll disconnect it now. Since I'm back in normal operation mode, the alarms are re-energized. In calibration mode, the alarms are not energized. Okay, I'll press the reset button here. And when the alarm level is between the low alarm and the high alarm, you can silence the audible. The lights will still flash. But once the reading drops back to below the low alarm set point, which right now is 0.3 is the reading, then you can reset the lights as well. Okay, That's a good demonstration of the alarms as well. So we're back to a normal operations screen. And basically, that's how you would use the potentiometers to calibrate the Eagle supertoxic sensor types. Thank you.